fourth dimension that they mention above. What do they mean by that? That is the thing.
Well, they call that transcendental state.
But what?
They can't describe what?
They can't describe it. See, supposing somebody has a low heartbeat, low pulse rate, or has a low consumption of oxygen or anything. Mm,
that's not transcendental state.
That is not a transcendental state, because you are still in the state where your attention is on your body.
Mm.
So it is not a transcendental. You have to transcendental means you have to jump onto the parasympathetic.
Mm.
See, we have four dimensions, we can say. One is the dimension of the left sympathetic. Another is of the right sympathetic. Then we have got the central nervous system, which is our conscious mind. And the fourth one is the parasympathetic. Does he jump on the parasympathetic?
We do.
Yes. In Sahaja Yoga, you jump onto the parasympathetic. Means your attention starts controlling the parasympathetic nervous system. Now how do we prove it? That we become the fourth dimension. First thing is that the person who becomes the controller of the parasympathetic becomes the auto. He can do things. He can do things. Like she can tell that another person is suffering on these centers without going to any laboratory, without going to any medical checkup, on the fingertips. So the person who becomes the fourth dimension, he becomes the auto, which is the autonomous nervous system, which is the auto part of it. He controls the parasympathetic. Now, when he controls the parasympathetic, he controls the supply to all the centers through certain movements, through certain kind of technique. For example, a person is suffering from some disease of the heart. Now, a normal person who doesn't have this fourth dimension will not know that he is suffering from any heart trouble. He will have no idea. He will never feel his heart or anything till he suddenly gets the attack and then he dies. But at the very onset of it, the person who is in the fourth dimension, that is the realized soul, can feel that something is going wrong with his heart. Also, he knows how to cure himself, the technique of curing himself. Also, he knows that he is the source of the medicines that he has to give, is the vital force. So this is the fourth dimension, is a great potential becoming a kinetic force.
Mm.
Like a egg becoming a bird. So the egg, we can see, egg has no way of flying out, but a bird can. There's tremendous difference between an egg and a bird. So such a person who gets realization and gets established is no more a person who can be tested by these machines and all that, because these machines deal only with the physical side. But it is he who can test. Even a child who is a realized soul can test another person. You don't need any machines for that. He becomes the one who diagnoses, he becomes the one who cures, he becomes the person who can soothe. Not only that, on physical level. But supposing somebody is emotionally disturbed, then such a person knows that another person is emotionally disturbed. He also knows precisely which center is disturbed. He also knows how to put that center right. You don't have to go to lunatic asylum to get cured. But a person who has fourth dimension can cure that person of that sickness because he precisely knows where the trouble is and how to. So all the diseases which are only physical can be cured, which are the psychosomatic can be cured, the combination of both can be cured. Any combination of these things can be cured by a person who is an established surgeon. But in case a disease has gone so far that it is irreparable, or something artificial has been introduced in the body, as they put sticks, steel sticks and all that, then Sahayoga doesn't work on dead thing. It works on living. If the organ is still living, it can work. But if it is not living, then it does not work. It works out on 80% of people. But the 20% of people on whom it cannot work out are the people who do not have a basic foundation to be a human being. They are like animals. Their attitude towards are animals, even worse than animals. So a state that could be the so-called fourth dimensions would be where a person is no more a human being. He becomes either a devil or a satanic person. This has to be accepted by medical science, that there are people who can be very devilish and they cannot ascend any further into the fourth dimension. The fourth dimension is not a mechanical process, but is a living process of the evolution by which you evolve to a higher being. But for that, you have to have some basic foundation. A person who is an alcoholic can be cured of alcohol. But a person who is cheating himself, cheating other people, is cruel to others, or say a person like Hitler, he cannot ascend. He's gone beyond that state where we cannot cure him. We can cure animals. We can cure human beings. But not people who are abnormal, or we can, there's no word for some, but satanic people. And that's how it doesn't work out in some people. Also the cases which have gone very down onto the state where we can say now, absolutely out of order. Then Sahaja Yoga allows such a body to take another birth and try. So because it's a fourth dimension, we cannot take medical science as a vehicle to express everything, because this is higher than that. But in many ways we can medically show that people have been cured of anginas, of cancer, of leukemia, of everything, through the vehicle of parasympathetic nervous system, which doctors cannot handle. Because they have their own limitation. They cannot jump onto the parasympathetic nervous system. And that is why they cannot cure a person who has problems of the parasympathetic. All problems can be solved through parasympathetic in case there are basic conditions, if they are fulfilled. In the medical science, people will even treat Hitler. There is no discrimination. But as you grow higher and higher, even in evolution, you become more discreet. And at this stage, you cannot treat a person who is a hypocrite, or who is a cruel man, or who is aggressive to others, or who is practicing methods to subvert people. And we have many gurus who take money and destroy many people just for money's sake. Such people can never go to the fourth dimension. Why should they talk about fourth dimension?